Down. It's far too large for where I'm at now. This is kept in my vehicle. And there's things in here that I simply don't need anymore. So I have a pair of BDU pants. I'm keeping these. I have a balaclava, which weighs nothing, so I'll probably keep that in there. T-shirt, short sleeve. This will stay in there. Tactical gloves. I have a lot of these. I actually have, I believe I keep a pair, a long pair and a short pair in the bag. The duty belt, I'm probably not going to keep the duty belt. There's another pair of gloves. These are not staying in the bag. This is a do-rag, not staying in the bag. Camouflage face paint. Why not? I'm actually going to replace the black gloves with the Coyote for this area. These are just more appropriate. These are the fingerless version. So I will probably keep these in here as well. We have, what do you know, a Shemagh. The Shemagh stays. Knee pads. In an urban environment, you may not want these. If you live anywhere where it's more rural or in the wilderness, if you're going to be in the desert or the mountains or the woods, I would definitely suggest a pair of knee pads. Here we have an Israeli gas mask with 3 40 millimeter canisters. That's staying. As far as the duty belt, there are parts of it that I may cannibalize. and put on, like, I don't necessarily think the handcuffs are necessary. The canteen, however, with the ferrule rod, I will probably keep in the bag. I have another small full tang tanto blade with, again, ferrule rod. But I have so many of them, I'll probably just leave this one on here. So I have plenty of knives and ferrule rods. Drop leg holster. I've got two of these, so I won't be needing this magazine pouch. I've got multiple ones. Survival knife. Again, I have probably six knives similar to this. So this duty belt is going to just basically be hung up in a closet as a spare. Pepper spray, and the other thing on here is an ASP baton. So nothing on this duty belt really needs to be carried with me. I don't need that. A tactical vest. Don't think this has much in it. It's a right-handed holster, so I don't even wear this. I really don't have any use for this vest, to be honest with you. This is not being used at all. It's not staying in the bag. And then to go along with the short sleeve shirt, I have a long sleeve shirt, which may never get used here, but I have it. And then I have blousing straps for the BDUs. Those of you who are ex-military know what blousing straps are. Not a necessity, but it's nice to have to keep your pant cuffs tucked up away from either getting hung up on your boots or getting wet. And then these are just liner belts for the duty belt to keep your duty belt attached to your waist. So again, not going to be needing that. So for the clothing bug out bag, what we're going to end up having here is a pair of BDUs, one long sleeve shirt, one short sleeve shirt, a chemog, knee pads, gas mask and filters, the blousing straps for the BDUs, and two sets of tactical gloves, and the camo face paint, and everything else is out of there. So I just cut my clothing bug out bag size and weight in half, probably more between the tactical vest and the duty belt. I may throw a couple more items in here, like something to start fires with, and possibly a weapon of some sort. Although with Arizona being open carry, I've always got a firearm with me anyway. And that just adds more weight. So this is pretty much going to be my clothing bag that's kept in the back of my vehicle. Yours may vary.